Welcome back, my friend, to another video. Today's video is going to be a Beebeecraft video. If you recall from my unboxing, I received these strainers, and I have used them also in a couple of videos. And I just got paint in this one, sorry. Sorry about that. And so I am going, and they didn't turn out quite the way that I wanted those pores to turn out. Not quite sure why. One of them I didn't even share with you. So I did it on a big 16 by 16, I believe it was. I might show it at some point. But anyway, so what I'm going to do here with these now is, jeez, should have done that before. I'm so sorry. I'm done with that. Okay, so anyway, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to use all three of these strainers. Floor drainer. And these ones didn't have packaging, so that's just what those ones look like. This one's got the hearts in it. And then this one's just a pretty little, like, flower shape. Because this one's flat, it may not, it's probably not going to go seep through there very well. It's just going to seep through the edges. That's okay too. That's fine. So I will use three different styles of paint as well. Because the one that didn't turn out so well, I used the Artist Loft Ready Pour pre-mixed paints. And I think, I'm not quite sure why that one didn't turn out very well, so I just hit my microphone. But it just kind of like washed out on the sides. I don't know if it's because it was so large. Maybe I didn't have enough of these paints. I don't know. But I'm going to try it again with the smaller canvas. So I'm going to use, on this one, I will use the violet premixed, the turquoise premixed. Well, they're all premixed, at least for this one anyway. And the metallic copper. Love this color. These paints have a sheen to them when they dry, so that's a bonus for these ones. I do like using these. This one here is a metallic white. They're a bit spendy. They're like $15 or $16 a bottle, I think. And then I will go with the aqua green for that pour or that strainer. And then for this one, I am going to go with a Floetrol and paint mixture. These are 4:1, and this is metallic cobalt blue. Beautiful color. This is Hooker's Green. Nice greeny color, kind of like an army green, in my opinion. And then I will use some black, contrast in between, and probably some white. I have it upside down because it's almost empty. That is Mars Black, and this is Titanium White. And then I have Prism Violet. And the Alizarin Crimson Hue Permanent. And then for, I will use those ones for this strainer. And then on this one here, I am going to use another mixture. This one is my glue wall mixture. 70% glue wall with 30%. Water. So that's those. The ones that I've been using for my balloon kisses. The colors that I will be using on that one are the metallic blue from Artist Loft and the put mortem, I forgot what it's called, under Amsterdam. And then this one is the yellowish green. by Amsterdam. And then in this one, it is Liquitex Titanium White. Okay, so let's go ahead and get these started. We will start off with this one here. So I'm just going to move this stuff out of my way for now to the side. Work my way around to these. Get this canvas out of my way. Okay, so let's go. I'm going to move this one just out there a touch. And I got my gloves. One glove. Okay. I hope you're having a good day today. Today is Saturday. It is August 28th. It has been a hot day here in Southern California. But beautiful. I did some resin work earlier. Not on my paintings, but some resin art. So looking forward to sharing those, which you probably will have already seen by the time this video gets put out. I get to demold those in the morning. Okay, so let's see here. What do we want to do first? I am going to go in with the aqua. Paint on the lid is sticking. I don't want the goo going in my cup, in my painting. See? Gunk. Gunk, 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 gunk. Oh, it's stuck to my finger. Stuck to my glove. Get off there. Okay. All right, let me just open all these up just to make sure they're going to be okay and not struggle with them like that one. There. All right, let's do this. So, that is how I am going to do that. Nope, that's how I'm going to do it. All right, so we're going to go with, you know, something I forgot to do is check how much paint I'm gonna need. Smooth move, Ange. Good one. All right, we're gonna go with blue, and then we're gonna go with some purple, the turquoise I meant, and then the aqua green. This will be my third and final for this round of Beebeecraft, and I hope that you have taken the opportunity to go check out their website, because they have got a ton of amazing things on that website, and I will have the link below in my description box for you. And if you want to become a YouTube or get your own free products, it's pretty easy. You have to have 100 subscribers, and that copper is just going to sink. Not liking that. You have to have 100 subscribers. You send them an email, and you get to spend $40, and they ship you your products. You do an unboxing video, unbagging, whatever you might want to call it, and then you do two other videos for them, and it's pretty awesome. I love doing it. Get free product, get to make some good videos, and yeah, it's fun. let's hope that this is going to be enough for this. I think so. This is all totally guessing and just going by eye here. That's going to be the last of that. Close all these lids up. And cross our fingers and pray for the best on this one. That copper just completely sank. I'll just go ahead and go on around here. Kind of a circular motion around that pin in the middle there. Pardon me. Ooh, I love what's coming out. I think I may have too much. That copper in there. It's finally coming out and it just totally sank to the bottom. Such a beautiful color. Oh no, it was looking good. I think I'm gonna stop there because that's probably plenty and I don't want this going off. So I'm gonna lift that up. Right there. Blow some bubbles off of that. Air bubbles. Look at the pretty colors. Hopefully it'll stay like that. Let me zoom you in a minute here. Excuse my fingers. So pretty. That was probably a bad zoom there. Okay, pull you back out some. And what do I want to do here? Before I do this, I am going to set up this little wire rack that came out of a refrigerator. Set this. Ooh, the colors are so pretty. Up. Oh, I don't want to get mud. Pull that back up. It's so pretty over here, but now this all this copper is turning to mud, and I don't like that. Save this corner here. It's pretty. Or the third time I've tried using these paints with a strainer and not one of them have turned out. So my synopsis would be that these paints are not made for this type of pour. That being said, I don't know what you would really want to use these for then. I mean, other than they're beautiful paints, but oh, look at. Perhaps I just had too much. Well, it's pretty. It's very pretty. And I will go ahead and set it over here. Okay, so we got that one. That copper. Decided to sink. Came out last, and it's pretty much almost all you see. I do have some nice lines, so I'm actually kind of digging the way that this one has turned out. However, you know, the original markings aren't there. That's all right. What I do have is really pretty, so I'm okay. All right, let's get this glove on and get this next one going. I'm trying to make this not too long of a video. All right, so what I'm going to do with this, layer them also the way I just did. Start off with some of this white. Again, I won't need too much. Let's get the lids off these. Or gloves. Lids. Gloves are not lids, Angie.
All my thoughts are running. Running around inside my head. Emotions keep coming. They're keeping me from thinking straight. Thought it would be different when I got my things in place. Stuck in this commotion. How come I ain't past this yet? I wanna me that be somebody else. Another me that doesn't need your help. But if I'm honest, I don't think we got it. I try to change the things you never liked. Try to make this better, make this right. But we're the same. Even though I changed, really made an effort, promised I would change, but something stayed the same. Wanted to do better.
Okay, so let's go ahead and get this one going. So I'm going to do the same with the little ring pour fashion. All right, beautiful cup, pretty. Okay, so let's go ahead and stuck my finger in it. Smooth, Angie. Oh, it's so pretty. All right, we'll just do it like this. I don't want all of that dripping out, so I'm going to lift it off of here. I got a little bit of mud there in the middle. All right, let's torch this one out. Really got to figure out these color combos. Ooh, look at the paints coming through on that. Colors. Okay, so let's go ahead and give this one a nice tilt. Oh, actually, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to put this on the edges to help it flow.
Thank you.
Call that one good.
Fix that side there.
All right, this one's cool looking. Not gonna stand up, so I'm gonna have to hold it so it doesn't do that. I'll do that. Okay, so this last one. Pardon that loud noise, my apologies. Okay. Love the rainbow-like effect that this one's bringing out here. Just getting popped some air bubbles off that. All right, so this one here, how do I want to do? Let's see. We're going to start. Just give them all a quick shake. And we're going to start with the blue. A nice squirt of that in there. And then I'm going to go with a dash of the purple, the prism. I love this purple. Oh, I got a paint booger in there. Paint booger. All right. Uh-oh, I didn't realize it was that empty. All right, and then we'll go with some red, Alizarin. And then I'm going to put a dash of the black in. A little contrast there. And then we'll go ahead and throw in some of this Hooker's Green. And we're going to throw in some of this white. Ooh, that was close. Almost lost it all. Okay, put that on the side. And then we'll come back in with some of the cobalt blue.
Everything feels so abstract. Yeah, it's complicated. What you say, the way you act. Well, it makes me so confused. I don't know what to do.
Side's pretty good. Yay. All right, and I'm also going to get 4 cups to put this painting on. it in. Okay, so here we go. I'm gonna hold on to this. And I'm just gonna pour right on top of that ball. Pretty cup. Okay. Lift this up some so it can drain out quicker. Not getting quite the strainer like a regular or colander pour. Got one of those videos. That turned out much better. But I gotta tell you though, that's pretty. A lot of black in there, but I had to get that contrast. But anyway, so they're fun regardless. I mean, this is all my error, I would say, because I'm not the best at color, you know, doing the color combos for pours yet. And I'm not gonna have, I'd like some flow extender. But I'm just going to go for it. Usually I would put some flow extender on there, but I don't have much left. So, well, actually, you know what? We'll use this paint. Still 4-1. Aqua green and turquoise. I'm buzzing. Let's drink up. You deaf look like big fun. Come on, let's get it on. Like that one Finn Gay song. I'm stunning. You love it. Come on, give me something. I know that you want it. Come on, give me something. The night is young and so are we. So maybe you should leave with me. The night is young and so are we. A little dark, but I love it. Totally see the colors that I used. You can see the alizarin, you can see the prism. Can't necessarily, actually you can see the hooker too. You can see the hooker. You can see the hooker in there. Look at that pretty little like tear shape thingy there. All right, well, let me take these gloves off and get this side scraped off. And I will bring you down for a closer look. Alrighty. So, as far as shapes go from these strainers, oh, it's so pretty. None of them kept their shape. None of them kept their design. That probably did the most, pardon the shadow. But right there, look at the copper. Look how pretty that is. Some nice pretty lines in this one, actually. Super pretty. Super, super pretty. I love the copper, and I love it with the purple. Beautiful, beautiful. Okay, that was the first one, and then the second one. And this one's got magnificent lines, and it's got some nice color. It is a little bit mud, not necessarily mud, but muted, maybe. It's more what I'm looking for. That's not necessarily my favorite, but it's kind of like a, I don't know, to me it's kind of like a jellyfish with long, what do you call it? It's little finny thingies. Finny things. Anyway. But look at the colors in this one. This is really pretty too. I really do like the way that this one turned out. The colors are beautiful in it. Okay. Feel those little bubbles in there. All right, and then on to the next one. This one is a bit darker. That's naturally because I put the black in there. But this one is beautiful. I love this. I'm trying to get a nice view without the shadow over here. And the coloring with that cobalt blue kind of reminds me of like peacock colors. Kind of sort of what I was going for. Look at all that. Just beautiful. There's a red in there. Pardon me. Kind of looks like an agate pull over here. And up in there is where you got the hooker's green. Stupid shadow. But, okay, so I will be back with these when they dry. And we'll see how they fare. Alright? I'll be back in a bit. Alright, so I wanted to see what these would look like with the lights off and the flash on. And you can see this one so much better. Phone was making a shadow for one, but now you get to see the shimmer in here. Love that right in there. Just simply beautiful. I love that little right there, that guy. Little teardrop. Okay, look at how pretty that blue is too in there. Oh goodness, it's all pretty. Alright, so let's see what the copper one has going for it. We know the other one doesn't have any shimmer in it because none of those paints are shimmery or metallic-y. Pretty, so pretty. Alright, so let me go ahead and let you go for now. I will be back. Dried results. All right, I am back with the dried results of the three strainer pours you just saw me do, and I just wanted to show you these pretty little earrings that I made in my last video. Beautiful, I love them. Excuse me. All right, so let's go ahead and show you these results. This is the first one with the heart, I believe. I did this one, right? Yes. No, this is not the heart one. This is the pink one. All right, let's see here. Trying to get a good angle. You can see pretty lines. But see the copper was heavier than all the rest of those paints. I'm assuming because it's got a mica in it. And yeah, sank. So that was the last thing that came out. So there you have that one. And as I was editing this, I noticed that the back of it looked like it wasn't taped up. And for some reason, I didn't tape up any of them. They had all been set up ready to go to be poured on. And so I thought that I had taped them and didn't. All right, so then we have here the second one. So what I'm gonna do with these is if I don't paint over them or whatever, I'm gonna paint over the back of that so you can't see the back of it. All right, well, here is the second one. This is the heart strainer. I love the colors of this. These ones blended really well together. Nice and bright. The center of it's a little bit dull. I should have lifted all three of these strainers and I didn't even think about it, but yeah, I should have. So here's this one, very nice. And then the final one with the Floetrol and just water, the 4-to-1, is this one. And I like the darkness of it. Ah! Oops. I like the darkness on this one. I like how they all just blended well together. Get a better view that way. Nope. Anyway, that's these. Let's see if I can turn it this way and get a good. This angle and this is not doing this picture any justice because I do like this one a lot. It is dark, but the colors look really well. And I think if I do end up resining this, the metallics will come out perfectly on it. There was one thing I want to show you right quick. Give me just 1 second. I let the paint dry in these cups, and this heart one, I peeled out the paint from it. And see the little hearts on it? Pretty cool, huh? Nothing I could do with that, but I just wanted to show you how cool it was looking, how it looked. All right, so that will conclude this round of my Beebeecraft videos. And I did get also these squirt bottles, which I have used in some previous videos. They weren't Beebeecraft videos, but these bottles are also Beebeecraft and they work really well for paints. I will put the video in the description box that I used these in, and I will also put the link for Beebeecraft for these and for all of the strainers that I used. And there is a link if you would like to join their program. You just have to have 100 subscribers. And you send them an email and you get to pick out $40 worth of merchandise, whichever merchandise it should be that you would like. And they send it to you free of charge. And it's nice. And you do your 3 videos and you're good to go. So with that being said, I'm going to go ahead and cut this video short because I'm trying to cut this part of it short, trying to get it out. So anyway, so have a good day. Have a good night, whatever it may be for you. Thank you. Beautiful. Anyway, so peace, take care, see you next time.